The following is a video clip from the webcast, Four Ways to Boost Simulation Data Processing Using Python. In this segment, Matt Ozalas talks about how to enhance analysis of measured data using simulation data. Matt shows us an example of de-embedding measured load pull data using EM analysis of a fixture.
So the second thing I'm going to talk about, well, we're going to stick by this load pull concept for the time being, and instead of simulating load pull contours, we're going to talk about measurement of load pull contours and de-embedding those measurements. So just like we generated the load pull contours in the simulation before, we can do it in measurement environment as well. And this is kind of a really basic load pull measurement setup. So we sweep a signal source, and then we sweep a load value, and we get the gain compression response for each load value. And the challenge here is that the device is in a fixture. So we take our device under test, maybe it's that transistor from the last example, and we put it in a fixture, and the measurement system is really going to give us load pull contours at the fixture plane, right? So when we measure it, we're going to have the fixture in there. And what we really want to do design is we want the load pull contours at the output of the device. So we want the shifted load pull contours to be de-embedded to the device plane. So there's a lot of ways to do fixture de-embedding. I think one good way, if you know what your test fixture looks like and you know what the substrate is to do an EM simulation. That's a really nice way to de-embed your test fixture. So the goal today is just to use an electromagnetic simulation to de-embed the measurement test fixture from this set of measured load pull contours for power transistors. So this might seem easy enough, but actually once you start digging into it a little bit, I realized that due to the structure here of the measured data, it's really difficult to generate contours in the simulation environment. The measured data comes in a very different format than we're used to dealing with in simulation. So if we try to just use the contour function that we have in the simulation, it's not going to really work very well. Just to give a little bit more detail of why, there's really two reasons. The values that come out of the measurement are decoupled from the ultimate load value. So if you're looking for efficiency, in simulation that's going to depend on the load. You're going to have the load listed and then efficiency values. But in the measurement system, it gets indexed. So the measurement sweep is mechanical, and each point on mechanical tuner is a different index value. So this is the result you get into the simulation. So this is decoupled data. The other issue is that the data is irregular. So the power sweeps don't all have the same number of points. And the reason for that is because we're trying to protect the device. If the device gets too high into compression, the system will just stop the power sweep because we don't want to damage the device. So difficult to deal with the data directly in the simulator, but we can deal with it over in Python. And the approach that I'm going to talk about is we'll create three new gridded array variables, which each contain explicit X, Y, and Z information. And then we can manipulate and plot that data however we'd like. So this is kind of how it works. To get any kind of meaningful 3D surface plot in Python, you need to interpolate the data onto a uniform grid. And what I mean by that is, this is what the simulation or measurement system kind of gives you. It's a bunch of scatter points. So you'll have X, in this case, which is the real load value. Then you'll have Y, which is the imaginary load value. And then you'll have a Z value. Maybe that's efficiency or power, whatever it is. And you just get a number of points that are taken by the measurement system. But what we need to get is a uniform grid. So we have to have the X and Y in a uniformly spaced manner. And then for each Z value, that needs to correspond to this gridded set of variables. So if I was doing this from scratch, I don't know where I'd even begin. It's difficult to think about. But in Python, the beauty is we've already got functions there to do that. So here I create a uniform X and Y grid, and then I use this mesh grid function, and that automatically builds the right 2D XY grid that I need based on the inputs. And for the Z value, we really need to interpolate that data onto this uniform grid because we only have scattered points in different places. So this grid data function in Python does exactly that. It uses cubic interpolation to put the Z values onto that uniform XY grid that I created. So now, pretty easily from this data, I've got three gridded plottable variables here, X, Y, and Z. And so basically, I can take those variables in Python and just plot things. I can plot a surface. There's a function to do that. And I can also generate contours. A surface plot and a contour plot are actually very similar if you think about it. It's really a way to represent three-dimensional data. So I can generate contours in this manner, and it's also possible to extract the data. So I can extract all of the points on this line out of Python. So now I'll talk a little bit about how I built this into the simulation flow. So we've got measured results. These are two different measurement systems that I've worked with. But this approach is general. This will work for any kind of data. If you've got your own custom measurement system or something, this will work just fine as long as you can specify which is power and which is load and which is efficiency. So we brought it into ADS using an MDIF file, and that came in to the simulation environment. So over in ADS, we do a little bit of filtering and manipulation of the data. So the user might specify what degree of compression they'd like, things like that. And then we pass this data into Python. And over in Python, this is where we grid the data and actually generate the contours. And then we return the contours to ADS. And once the contours are back in the simulation environment, then we can take our EM simulation of our test fixture, and we can just de-embed that from the measured contours. So this is something we can do with math. We don't need Python for this part of it. We can just use a little bit of math to de-embed those contours in the simulation tool. So let me demo that for you. So here I've got a data display, and this just has data from a measurement system that I've imported. So this is from a Mowry system. And the data that came in from Mowry is just all these columns of data, and they're kind of all indexed. And this is what the result is. It's just a simulation a data display template. And when I move the marker, for example, everything just changes. So this is different gain compression values, and all of these different plots are updating based on those gain compression values. The only thing that's different about this than any other, load pull data display template is that these contours here are generated over in Python, and it just happens in the background. You don't even see it. When I move the marker, everything just updates, and it happens automatically. So just to give you a little bit of a background of how this works, we wrote a function to generate contours from general data. So if you pass in data out of ADS, we can generate contours from that data using this script. And, we pass in a few specs, we pass in the data, and then we call the script. And the beauty of it is we can rerun the script over and over again to generate contours for different things. So I actually invoke this script. When the marker gets moved, the script is invoked twice. It's invoked once for efficiency and once for power. So that allows me to rerun the same script, reuse the code, and generate contours based on essentially any kind of irregular indexed weird data. So once we've got those contours, the de-embedding process is pretty easy. I just have a set of S parameters for a network, and that'll ship the contour. So the dotted lines are the measurement system contours, and the solid lines are the de-embedded contours. And it's not super interesting to show you the de-embedding from the EM simulation, because it's basically this. It's just two different sets of contours. But I thought maybe instead what I would do is just show you how you could take any kind of network, S-parameter network, and just de-embed it using this type of approach. So if I tune here, then I can take these parameters, and what I'm going to actually do is de-embed the contours that I have. So here I'll tune a simple LC network, and what you'll see is the contours will kind of move around as I change the values of L and C. So this de-embedding is being done on a measured set of contours, and of course, depending on what your fixture looks like, you can even play around with what your fixture might look like and see how the contours may shift based on that.